Course outlines or syllabus documents are important documents in instructional programs. One of the most important things that they do is that they communicate to the learner and they try to answer questions ahead of time or provide information about the course. It helps learners anticipate how the course runs and how to organize their learning. And sometimes, most importantly, it can prevent misunderstandings and establish expectations about assignments and grading and so on and so forth. As you will see when we move forward and talk about the components within a course outline, grading procedures, student policy, absentee policy, you know, these types of details can be important components to have within a course outline or syllabus to establish an agreement between the learner and the student. They're also used by administrators for a variety of reasons in terms of program planning, grading procedures, and even looking at transferring credits between institutions. They're very effective communication tools, and they have a format that you do want to follow. Now, once again, we do need to stress that the components that you will include in your course outline or syllabus will be somewhat dependent upon what you have with your institution. So if you're at a formal institution, you have a formal template that you're going to follow. You're going to include all those components. You will justify what you've done within your rationale. Now, if you're in a situation where you're doing a workshop or you don't have a formal template to use, well, then what we want you to do is to, or we want to provide for you is sort of key components and talk about these key components and the role that they play and why you will want to include them. So I just want to address that. A cover page can be useful. It's an optional item, some people find it very useful, some people don't. One of the most important things that you do want to include in your course outline is a purpose. Now, I've got these items starred here, and these are the starred items that you do need to include in your assignment. So this purpose really provides an overview of what the course or program is about. If you've got an outcomes-based course, what the learner ultimately will be able to do, and it really points to that bigger, broader picture. Similarly, all outlines and syllabus have to have goals or outcomes, and these will come directly from your DACOM or from your course profile outcomes guide or outcomes map. Course outline, a syllabus will often, almost always include a prerequisite, and you've got to be careful with prerequisites, because a prerequisite is something that has to be checked and verified. And so you can point to previous courses as a prerequisite, but if you suggest that a certain level of computing skill is a prerequisite, well, then the institution would have to test that, and it may require a student to actually formally take a course to justify that prerequisite. This is where the recommended learner characteristics can come in quite handy, because you can specify, computer capability or ease of use or comfort with a computer or the ability to work with different types of programs and software as a learner recommended characteristic that wouldn't have to be verified by the registrar's office. So it'll give you some flexibility. Another item that is extremely important is the course format. Is it online? Is it lecture-based? How will it run? Are there labs? All the aspects of the way the course is set up. Similarly, course activities, instructional activities. Is this lecture-based? Is there going to be a co-op, for example? Are there workshops? Are there field trips? All the learning types of activities, I think, are going to need to be included to give your learner an understanding of what to be expected. A course text is often included in your outline. Now, we've indicated that it is optional, and the reason that it might be optional is that you can give your instructors the flexibility of using a variety of different texts depending on what their preference is. So, again, but it is a useful thing. Supplies and equipment. What does a student need to bring? What will be provided? What is required? For example, if you have a course where students are required to have certain attire and gear, gear and wear that they wear, they bring to class, you would specify those types of things. The schedule of sessions is going to be extremely important. Identifying when you meet, the class times, what's the period of duration of the course, if there's testing times, all of those aspects of the schedule need to be included. The student evaluation, what are the assignments, you know, how many assignments, what are the grades, what's the percentage, what are the expectations. That's extremely important. Students do need to know how they will be evaluated, and this really does provide an aspect of that agreement between the learner and the teacher. Course policies, even though they are optional, have become quite important. I know in some larger institutions there is a section at the later end of a syllabus where you'll have student expectations and course policies, things that deal with plagiarism, attendance, a whole assortment of expectations, inclusive language, all those types of things, all those policies that are going to be really important. Now, if there's any challenges within a learning environment, there's issues with students, quite often administrators will take a look at and ask the instructor if there was a policy that would have been specified that would deal with a certain issue. So course policies can be an extremely important factor, and they can be actually added to the end or be provided in a separate section of the syllabus or outline. And then additional information that is necessary. Once again, the reading that we have provided for you is going to really provide all the details you need to make these decisions, to be able to understand what you need to include in your outline or your syllabus. And then more importantly, it'll give you the reason and the rationale that you will include in your rationale document. So again, if you need any assistance, any support in developing your course outline or syllabus, don't hesitate to contact us.